This is part one of simplifying complex fractions. A complex fraction is a fraction whose numerator and or denominator contains a fraction. So I've got four examples here. Each one has either a fraction in the numerator or a fraction in the denominator, or it might have a fraction in the numerator and the denominator. There are a couple methods for simplifying a complex fraction. I'm going to start with method one. You would simplify the numerator and the denominator of the complex fraction, so each is a single fraction. And then we're going to multiply the fraction in the numerator by the reciprocal of the fraction in the denominator. That's because it's a basic division problem. The top is the numerator divided by the whole thing, and the bottom is the denominator, and when you divide fractions, you can multiply by the reciprocal. And lastly, we would simplify. So let's look at an example. All right, here's an example with numbers 2 3/4 over 5/8. So what I would do is I could write the numerator as just a single fraction. So that would be 4 times 2 is 8 plus 3 or 11/4 divided by 5/8. Now what this means is you've got 11/4 divided by 5/8, right? I can write that out if you'd like to see the division first. And then remember, when you divide by a fraction, it's the same thing as multiplying by the reciprocal. So that's really 11/4 times 8/5. So you could go directly from this step to this step. You take the numerator, and then you multiply by the reciprocal of the denominator. Remember, it's the denominator. That's what you take the reciprocal of. And then we simplify this, cancel if possible. 4 goes into 8 twice. And so my answer to this problem would be 22/5. And that's reduced. You don't need to change that to a mixed number. And I've just simplified one with numbers. Now let's do one that has some variables. All right, how would we work this problem? 5 plus 2 over x over x plus 3 over 4x using method 1. What it's saying to do is first simplify the numerator so it's just a simple fraction, and the denominator so it's a simple fraction. So if we look at the numerator, we need a common denominator. So what would that be? Actually, I think I'll go down the page. What would the common denominator be? You would have to multiply this by x over x, so you have a common denominator of x. So the numerator will be 5x plus 2 all over x. Okay? We got that from how do you add fractions. All right, now what about the denominator? So I've just simplified the top so far, right? Into 5x plus 2 over x. Now we're looking at the denominator. And what's the common denominator here? It's 4x, because there's only one denominator. So I need to multiply this x. Remember, that could be thought of as an x over 1 by 4x over 4x. All right, so what does that give me for the new denominator down here? I'm going to have a 4x squared, right, plus 3. 4x squared plus 3. Over the denominator is the same, right, is 4x. All right, so now what we've done is we've written the numerator as just a single fraction and the denominator as a single fraction. So what does that give me? Well, you take the numerator times the reciprocal of the denominator. Remember, you're going to do the reciprocal of the denominator. So what's the reciprocal? The 4x is then in the numerator, and the 4x squared plus 3 is in the denominator of the fraction. Okay, now, to simplify it, I want to factor and cancel. Well, this is factored, right? And this can't be factored any further. And so I can cancel my x's, right? So finally, what do I have left in the numerator? I've got a 4 times a 5x plus 2. Now you can leave it in factored form, or you could do the distributive property So this is a perfectly fine answer in factored form, or you could write 20x plus 8 in the numerator by doing the distributive property over 4x squared plus 3. That's also perfectly fine. So I'm using method one. I'm simplifying the numerator, I'm simplifying the denominator, so each of them are single fractions, and then you multiply by the reciprocal. Keep in mind, that's because this means 5x plus 2 over x divided by 4x squared plus 3 over x. And when you divide by a fraction, you multiply by the reciprocal. Sorry, I meant to put 4x here. There we go. Here's one for you to try. X over x plus 2 over 2 over 3x plus 6. Now, using method 1 would be easy in this particular problem because I already have a single fraction in the numerator and a single fraction in the denominator. So put the video on pause and try this one. Okay, let's see. So what does this mean? I'm going to take the numerator and I want to divide by the denominator. So that's the same thing as taking the big numerator up here and timesing it by the reciprocal of the denominator, right? Okay. Now, instead of writing the 3x plus 6 in the numerator, I'm going to note something. I'm going to have to factor that to simplify. So let's factor the 3x plus 6. That's going to be in this numerator over here, and that's 3 times x plus 2. Okay? And then the 2 will go in the denominator because I had to take the reciprocal right here from this big denominator. Okay, now, can anything cancel? Well, yes. The x plus t's cancel, and that's it. So I end up with 3 times x, which is 3x, over 2. So this method 1 is especially easy if you already have a single fraction in the numerator and a single fraction in the denominator. There's another method that we like to use, some people find easier, when you don't have a single fraction in the numerator and denominator. And I'm going to do the problem we just did before this one here using that new method. As a reminder, this is the problem we did, 5 plus 2 over x over x plus 3 over 4x, and we got for our answer 4 times 5x plus 2 over 4x squared plus 3. Okay, instead of telling you the steps for the new method, I'm going to do it, and then on the next video, we'll do more problems using this second method. All right, here's the second method. You look at the denominators that are in the numerator or the denominator. So in other words, you look in the numerator of this big complex fraction and you say, what's the least common denominator of the denominators you see here and all the denominators you see in the denominator? And that would be 4x. 4x is the least common multiple. So the new method is you multiply numerator and denominator by the least common denominator. Right, so what do I mean? I'm going to take the whole numerator and the whole denominator of the complex fraction and multiply by the LCD. All right, that would be 4x, right? Because there's only an x in the big numerator and there's a 4x in the bottom numerator. So I'm going to multiply the whole top one by 4x and the whole bottom one. Now, the reason we do this is because this will eliminate any fractions in the big numerator. All right, so watch what happens. I have to do the distributive property, 4x times 5 plus 4x times 2 over x. That's what I get in the big numerator when I distribute the 4x. And I'm going to do 4x times x plus 4x times 3 over 4x. Now check this out. The x's cancel here. The 4x's cancel here. And I get a problem without any fractions because I end up with 20x plus 8 in the numerator. And in the denominator, I end up with a 4x squared plus 3. All which is exactly the same as when we use this other method, except I just happen to do the distributive property. Instead of writing it as 4 times 5x plus 2, I've got 20x plus 8. Now, after you do this, you would see if you can factor and cancel. In this case, factoring doesn't change anything. All right, so we'll be using this new method if you go on to the next video.